One final word about the East-West arms talks in Wyoming this weekend. It turns out that the visitors from the East are right at home out West. Why? Maybe because they've been watching a lot of old movies. David Dow reports.
It is a rare departure from the usual settings for high-level diplomacy. Jackson Hole, a living landscape of the old American West, but just perhaps a perfect place to make the Soviets feel at home. This is a Russian Western, replete with cowboys and Indians.
Our people know quite a lot about cowboys, and they like stories about cowboys.
They like the story, they like the image of cowboy, a romantic one.
Just ask Chuck Connors, recipient of a Leonid Brezhnev bear hug back when Connors was riding tall in TV Westerns.
The Western is very intrusive all over the world in a positive way.
The trouble is, the Wild West of Western movies is rapidly being tamed. The Soviet visitors can still ride in a covered wagon, but the wheels are by Goodyear. If you want an Indian ambush, you have to pay for it. And those strangers around town in the big hats, the ones by the old dry goods store now offering designer duds, are most likely tourists.
We've switched. The herds are different. The last, the old West used to be cows. Now it's visitors.
But be not dismayed, says Chuck Connors. There's still plenty of old West here, if the Russian visitors but look for it.
The atmosphere of Wyoming, bucolic, rural, mountains, streams, cowboys, fresh, individual America. Let's cheer it. Let's not laugh at it.
And out on the range, the real cowboys have looked forward to their own brand of glasnost.
I bet the Russians have a good time. They come in the cowboy bar on Saturday night. You know, we Doug, I'm sure, will buy them the first round. We don't have to fight them the last round.
So cheers, Russian visitors. Poyekova. There may be pet llamas in the old corral these days and Jiffy photo shops downtown, but even in the new West, some things never change. David Dow, CBS News, Los Angeles.